clear. Are we clear? Clear for liftoff. Take off. For making reverberations. Are we affirmative? No negatory. Come in, come in. Radio, what's your story? Ayahuasca kilo. Will you welcome? Are you ready for a better Echo Victor? Feeling wider than awake. Yeah. Better quicken than straight.
Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. Saturday Baseball on the show. It's the Chicago Cubs, the Arizona Diamondbacks. Just about set to go. And towing the slab here, Zach Gallen. Chris, you don't have to dig too deep into the numbers to see how good he's been.
Well, he's been a very dependable starter for his club. And what stands out for me is that left-handed hitters have really struggled batting below 200 against him. And it just tells me they have a hard time tracking the baseball. Maybe it's the release point. Maybe it's the motion, but just some way, somehow, they've got to figure out a way to pick it up and try to have some success from the left side.
Pitch misses there. One ball, one strike. Check swing, but he went too far. And the count, 1-2. And there's a fly ball deep right field. Pretty well struck. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. One out in the top of the first.
Well, that slider was way out of the zone. And for me, it just comes down to not seeing the pitch out of the hand, not tracking it into the zone, and then also being a little bit anxious, not confident in your two-strike approach. And so when a guy's in that position, you get him to commit early, and a lot of times you get the swing and miss, as you did right there.
Now here is Seiya Suzuki. Next pitch misses outside, and that's ball one. And the righty deals. Strike two.
I got to count 1-2.
Swing and a bouncer. Zips it across. Two quick outs at the top of the first here tonight. Time now for the Chicago Cubs lineup. This is a good offense, Chris. You're going to get quality at bats and balls put in play consistently with this group.
And it doesn't really matter who they're facing on the mound. They have the ability to go out and compete and win ball games. If it's an All-Star or Cy Young Award winner to just a rookie up in the big league. So when you have that, you have a chance to win every night. If I was a pitcher on this team, I'd feel pretty good about taking the mound for them.
Here's the 0-1. Clips the corner. 0-2 now.
Is there a little wrinkle to that?
I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
Got him looking. That's out number three. And the Cubs are down in order. On to the bottom of the first. No score. Bottom of the first. And now it's Dalton Varsho.
Leading up for the Diamondbacks, the center fielder, Dalton.
The pitch.
Varsho.
That's in there. Strike one. 0-1. Oh and two as he waves at that one. Hendricks. And a foul ball, he stays alive. On the ground to third. One gone, bottom half of the first. Time to take a look at the Diamondbacks lineup. And so far this year, this has not been a very good offense.
Well, in this day and age, if you can't slug and get on base, that OPS has to be at a certain level. If you're going to produce runs, give your pitchers an opportunity as they're facing tough offenses as well.
Yeah, the batter now, Paven Smith. In there for strike one. Right-hander kicks, deals. Just missed.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Next pitch is downstairs. Next one misses. 3-1.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
In for a strike. Now it's 3-2. Kicks and deals. Got him. And two away now.
Batting third, the left fielder, Javon.
Two outs, bases empty. David Peralta at the plate. Bounce to the right side. Play made, that ends the inning. And the Diamondbacks down in order. We played an inning, no score. Back here at Chase Field, here's Yan Gomes.
Leading off for the Cubs, the catcher, Yan Gomes.
Gallen back to work. Hit hard on the ground to short. Tosses to first, one up, one down.
That is good. The third baseman, number 16, Patrick Wisdom.
Here's a big power threat. Patrick Wisdom. That one's in there, 0-1.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Ed Drummond, our umpire behind the plate in this one.
Yeah, Book, he's a really fair umpire, both the pitchers and the hitters. So standard strike zone, he's consistent with it. And the great thing is you don't see players questioning the calls too much. So that's a good thing in this day and age.
Next one just misses. And it's 1-2. Singy, what kind of strike zone is most frustrating for hitters?
I'd say off the plate, away. and down. And why? Those are the toughest locations to hit the baseball.
Well, big power guy right there, the generating so much bat speed. It's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. They tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
And now, Frank Schwindel. The pitch. Swings through that.
One and one.
Late that time, and it's strike two.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
The next pitch misses. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. 3-2 now. No score here in the second. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Payoff pitch. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk. So two down, Jason Hayward, the next cup to hit. And a foul ball. The 0-1. Up the middle, sneaks through, base hit. They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
Batting it, the second baseman,
Jonathan Villar up to hit. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Second inning here, no score. Next pitch inside, and that's ball two.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Two-oh. That one ripped right center field. Back there. Turning and looking, and it's gone. Jonathan Villar goes deep. That's his 99th career homer. And they throw three on the board. It's 3-0.
With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
Here's Nico Horner.
Batting nine, the designated hitter.
And that's in there for strike one. Horner. The wind to kick the pitch. Now a pop up on the infield. Walker makes the catch, and that'll do it. So the Cubs get three on this blast. It's now 3-0. Welcome back, and now it's Christian Walker. The Diamondbacks in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at-bat out of him right here.
Walker.
This one chopped up the middle. Contreras gets it to first. And quickly one away in the second.
Batting fifth. The third baseman.
Here's Josh Rojas. Swings and sends a rocket to right. Suzuki pulls that one down, and there's two away.
this lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing him down. He's settling in. You've got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Ketel Marte takes the ball here as he stands in now. Next offering is in for a strike. Next one misses, and a count 2-1. Ripped towards third, and he can't come up with it. No throw. He's safe at first.
Batting depth, the designated hitter, Jordan Luplow.
Now batting, Jordan Luplow. Squirts away a little bit. Rolled over to third. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. Save.
He's safe.
What an effort there to save the perfect game, but it's broken up on an infield hit.
That's back-to-back singles for him. Yeah. You can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
First and second with two outs. Nick Ahmed here to hit. That's hard hit in the line. And that will end the inning. Diamondbacks strand a pair. They trail in this one 3-0. Back here at the ballpark, onto the third inning. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Wilson Contreras.
The shortstop.
Possibly thinking about home run number 100 here. He's just one shy of that milestone.
The right-hander back to work. And first offering is fouled off.
Been a rough start on the mound for this guy. His third inning so important for him to get on track, turn the page, settle in, do all those things you need to do to give your team a little bit of length in this one.
And a pitch. And a pop up right side, foul territory. Walker racing over to make the catch.
Now batting, right fielder, Suzuki.
Now the number two hitter, Seiya Suzuki, grounded out his first time.
Looking good, Diamondback.
Pitch misses inside, and that is ball one. Next offering is down low. And now 2-0. The 2-1. And he flips a breaking ball in there. Or a changeup.
Either one. Something off speed. Good arm action on it. Whatever it was.
And a 3-2. On the ground at first. and he takes it himself for the out.
The left fielder, number 8, Ian Happ.
Two outs, base is empty. Now the left fielder, Ian Happ.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
In there, and it's 0-1. Check swing, but he went too far. And it's 0-2. And 1-2. Next pitch is popped up. Walker drifts towards it. He's got it, and that'll do it. Three up, three down for the Cubs, but they're on top by a count of 3-0. Back here in the desert, and now here is Jose Herrera.
Leading up for the Diamondback, the catcher, number 36.
Hendricks back to work. That one fouled off. Next one in the dirt.
I got a ball, one strike.
Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. That one ripped. Can't get there, and now maybe extra bases. Fires to second too late, and he's got a double.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ballgame, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
And now the center fielder, Dalton Varsho.
The center fielder, number 12, Dalton.
Hard hit to third.
Varsho.
Wisdom on to first. One gone, bottom of the third inning.
The batter, the right fielder, Pavin.
Now it's the right fielder, Pavin Smith.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Ripped on a line. Can't get there. Base hit. The run comes in from second, and now just a two-run deficit.
Drove that ball nicely, put a great swing on it, and it jumped off his bat. Kind of put it all together there, and he's rewarded with the double.
Here's the left fielder, David Peralta.
Now batting, left fielder, David Peralta.
Next pitch downstairs, ball one. And the 1-0. This one smoked out to left. Pat makes the play. Two down.
It was all over that fastball right there. Tell you what, if he gets under it just by a fraction of an inch or a little bit more, that's way back.
Christian Walker stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Smith headed for the plate. Check that. He'll stop at first with a single after putting on the brakes. The run comes in from second. It's 3-2.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there was just no one there to knock it down.
Josh Rojas stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Now batting, third baseman, Josh.
And first offering is fouled off. This to third. They get the force. Inning over. On to inning number four. It's the Cubs 3 and the Diamondbacks 2. And welcome back. On to the fourth. Now it's Yan Gomes.
Leading off for the Cubs, the catcher, Yan Gomes.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Next pitch, not close, up high. Next offering upstairs. Yan Gomes waits. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Here's the third baseman, Patrick Wisdom. He was a strikeout victim his first time.
Wisdom.
First offering misses the mark. The 1-0. Inside, just missed.
Well, he looks more focused at the plate and working the count after that first at-bat strikeout.
And now two balls and a strike.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Two-one pitch is in there, and the count is even. Runner at first with no outs here. Stays alive. The 2-2. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Patrick Wisdom circles the bases, and they add to the lead. It's 5-2.
Looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
So up now for Chicago, Frank Schwindel.
Now batting, the first baseman, Frank.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Next offering misses, and a count even 1-1. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a line drive caught.
Up next for the Cubs, the center fielder, Jason.
Here's Jason Hayward.
Hayward.
And that one fouled off. Lined into left center, base hit. Around first, heading for two. In safely, it's a double, and his second hit.
Wasting no time, he's now two for two now on the night, baseman. And just a Jonathan triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, We're starting with this already. Jonathan Villar, the next to hit. First pitch, and he has to get out of the way. One out and a runner at second.
Shut them down now.
Oh, that ball got him pretty good out there on the mound. On to first, and there's two away. They turn things over to the southpaw, Kyle Nelson. He's been so good against lefties.
So at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Nico Horner, the next Cub to hit.
Up next for the Cub, the designated hitter, Nico Horner.
First offering misses badly for ball one. The lefty, the 1-0. Late swing, fouled off. The next pitch misses, 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Man at second. That one inside. Now 3-1. 2 outs and one in scoring position. And ball four to aboard.
Now batting.
And up to hit is Wilson Contreras.
Well, the way these two teams have battled in this game, you know you need more. Got to continue to add runs if you're going to get out of here with a win.
First pitch, not close.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation, or maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
First and second, two down. Next pitch is outside. Three oh down. On the ground. Inning over, and it could have been worse. Cubs had two on this homer. It's now 5-2. When I come out, they run out. I'll be working that stage to the sun out. Your boy cooked them. Bottom of the fourth, and now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Ketel Marte.
Leading up for the Diamondbacks, the second baseman, Ketel Marte.
And a pitch. And a base hit up the middle.
Right there, does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
The designated hitter, Jordan Luplow.
Jordan Luplow stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Ground ball, left side, and there's a hit. throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one. Ripped it down the line. Nice job of standing his mechanics.
Oh, man.
Nick Ahmed stands in now for the Diamondbacks. In there for strike one.
Well, the offense has gotten going, and a pitcher wants to go out there, have a real quick inning, get those guys back into the dugout so those bats can stay hot.
And the right-hander deals and delivers outside. He was looking to come up with the shutdown inning and off to a shaky start. The 1-1. Swing and a miss. And a count one and two.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Righty delivers. Now that's smacked to right center. Suzuki puts the squeeze on that one. Runner tags up for third. And he moves up 90 feet. Runners at the corners now. One away.
The batter, number 36.
Now up next for Arizona, Jose Herrera. That one's in there, 0-1.
In this situation, the batter's got to know what the pitcher's trying to do to him, and that's trying to get him to hit the ball on the ground, get 2-for-1. You got to look for something up in the zone. At worst case scenario, you deliver the sacrifice fly.
Runners are at the corners, one away. Ripped to first, caught. Race to the bag, but he's safe. Good job to avoid the double play.
The batter, the center fielder, Varsho.
Back to the top of the lineup, Dalton Varsho stands in now for the Diamondbacks. And first offering is fouled off. Base hit, center field. One run is in. Headed for the plate. He'll score as well, and they trail by one. And a great start to the inning. A leadoff triple puts the tying run at third.
Well, here we are, third time through the order, and this is where we see the OPS jump up. Manager might have to go to the bullpen a little bit sooner than he anticipated.
So a runner at third, two men out. Haven Smith now at the plate.
Now batting, the right fielder, Haven.
In there, and it's 0-1.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
At the belt and fires. That one drilled left field, and that's a fair ball. The run scores from third. It's 5-5. And in its second with an RBI double.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bit the other way.
And it's scoring position with two away. Next up for the Diamondbacks, David Peralta.
The left fielder.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. Next one is off the play. Two balls, no strikes, the count. 2-0. Here's the sinker at the knees for a strike. Here comes the pitch. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Pat makes the catch, and that'll do it. We played four. We're all tied up 5-5. Back here at Chase Field, and now the right fielder, Seiya Suzuki.
Leading off for the Cubs, the right fielder, Seiya Suzuki.
And he deals. In there at the knees, it's 0-1. The Diamondbacks with some movement in the pen. Humberto Castellanos preparing to come on if needed. Kicks and fires. This to center field, and that's a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
The left fielder, number 8, Ian.
Ian Happ up to hit. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Nobody out. Runner at first. Next offering is in for a strike.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
The next offering misses, and the count is 1-2. Just a slow ground ball this time. One at second to Walker, and that's two.
Up next for the Cubs, the catcher, Yan Gomes.
And next for the Cubs, Yan Gomes. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Foul off down the right side. Wait. And a count 1-2. Two down, nobody on. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Turned on, but foul wide of third. The pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's a 2-2. Oh, now this one's high and deep. Way back there. On its way. Gone. Yan Gomes hits one out, and the Cubs have the lead now. It's 6-5. We take another look as StatCast tells us that ball took off at 110 miles an hour.
And plenty of distance as well. I mean, that was an impressive home run, but he squared it up and knew it was going.
So two away with nobody on. And up next for Chicago, Patrick Wisdom. First offering, and it just misses. And now the lefty. And that one cutting but missing down low. This one smacked out to left center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that is that. Cubs get one on the solo shot. It's now 6-5. Welcome back. And here's the first baseman, Christian Walker.
Leading up for the Diamondbacks, the first baseman, Christian Walker.
The pitch. There's a strike. That one misses. 1-1. The 1-2. This one chopped on the ground, but foul.
Now, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
The punch out there, and the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth. Now the third baseman, Josh Rojas.
The third baseman.
And that's in there for strike one. Next pitch misses, and now it's even 1-1. Gets him to chase after that one.
1-2.
And here it comes. That one is hammered right field. On its way. Turning and looking, and it's gone. He flexes his power with that swing. His first homer of the year. It's 6-6.
Not every home run is a majestic blast off the bat, and even though he hit it pretty well, it was anything but a sure thing to get out. But today, the conditions were right. He got just enough of it, and I think the backspin really helped that thing go.
So it's all tied up thanks to the home run. Ketel Marte up to the plate.
The batter, number 4, second baseman.
Next offering is down low. 1-0.
Marte.
And the 1-0. Just missed. And that's in for a strike. Next offering is down low. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. To the right side. Can't glove it cleanly. Throw to first. Gets him. Good job to stay with it there for the second out.
Now back. The designated hitter, Jordan Luplow.
Jordan Luplow stands in now for the Diamondbacks. In there for strike one. Now a screamer into the outfield. Line drive. Oh, he dropped it. It's a double. Third hit of the night for him.
everything was mechanically sound with that swing right there. I mean, that's pretty much what you're wanting to replicate with every rep you take. You want good balance, barrel directly to the baseball, and good long extension after contact out in front of home plate. Man, there are a lot of doubles in a swing like that. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
So two down now, and here is Nick Ahmed.
The batter number 13. Good stop. Nick.
First offering misses the mark.
Come on, Nick. You can do this.
And a pitch. Now fly ball to right center. Suzuki on the move. Racing makes the catch. And that is that. D-backs get one on the solo jack. And we're all even now at six apiece. Back here at the ballpark. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. So up now for Chicago, Frank Schwindel. Nelson back to work. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Next pitch is outside. That's a laser base hit.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
And now Jason Hayward trying to move him over here. Slings to second, out there, but that's all they'll get.
The batter, number 24, second baseman, Jonathan Villar.
Jonathan Villar getting ready to hit.
Runner!
There goes Hayward. Line drive, and that one gets down, fair ball. Hayward rounds third, headed for the plate. Throw home, he beats it, and it's a 7-6 game.
Well done, drives in the run. He really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach, his head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it.
Man at second with one away. Now it's the DH, Nico Horner. He's 0 for 1. Pickoff throw, and he's back in safely. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Ball one, no strike.
The 1-0. That's to third. Reaches on the backhand, but it's through. Stop sign goes up at third. Runners at the corners with one out.
Back-to-back base hits. Turned on it nicely. Definitely a little out in front of the pitch, but he didn't hook around it too much and was able to keep it fair down the line. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Wilson Contreras now up to the plate. He's sitting on 99 career homers. We'll see if this is the moment to notch number 100. Nelson picks to first. Horner gets back easily. That one fouled hard the other way. First and third, one down. That's a base hit as a run scores.
That's now three hits in a row for the offense. Pitch was on now the outside, didn't the go the field. Other way with it, but still a nice job of using the big part of the field to find a hole. No way he hits it that well if he hooks around the baseball there.
A new arm into the game, the righty, Humberto Castellanos. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. Seiya Suzuki will hit next for the fourth time tonight. Swings through that one. 0-1.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
And the 0-1. Swung out, belted. That's back there. That skips over the fence, so it's an automatic double as a run scores.
Well, everyone is thinking, Ed, would the runner have scored from first if the ball stayed in the bar? We'll never know, but they do get a run across with a chance to do more damage in the inning.
And next for the Cubs, Ian Happ. In the air to left center, Peralta on the move, drops into the glove, runner tags from third. He'll score the sac fly. It's 10-6.
There you go. Nice little RBI there. It's a great at bat. Got the job done.
Now batting, the catcher, Yan Gomes.
Gomes stands in with two away as he takes a ball. Activity in the bullpen. Joe Mantiply, the left-hander, up and throwing. Middleton getting cranked up as well. Runner at second, two down. Next pitch misses way outside. Bounced up the middle. Ahmed handles. On the run, throw to first. Third out. 9-1 and 2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. It's the Cubbies 10 and the Diamondbacks 6. Back here in the desert. Well, we go bottom six. Now the D-backs catcher, Jose Herrera.
The catcher, number 36.
And a pitch. That's in there. Strike one. Bounce to the left side. And foul ball. Righty to the plate. That misses the zone. Now 1-2. To third. That one sizzling on its way through to the outfield.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at-bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. Just found a way to slap that ball down the third baseline. That's really excellent back control. It kind of goes back to all those drills you see hitters do off the tee where it's placed in different spots, which is nice.
The left-hander on now, Daniel Norris. Hasn't pitched in the last 3 days.
Well, I think that what makes him so tough against left-handers is he hides the ball for a long time. And from that same side, harder for you to determine which part of the plate it's going to end up on.
Next to hit, Dalton Varsho. Base hit. That was smoked through the infield. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
Now batting, the right fielder.
Now the number two hitter, Paven Smith. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Michael Givens getting loose out there. Thompson warming up as well. No outs, runners at first and second. In the dirt. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Pereira around third. Throw is offline and he scores. It's 10-7.
Stringing them together. That's three hits in a row. Got a change up and a pretty good one too. Outside corner, but he just got extended and put the barrel on it. Shody has a lot of plate coverage on that swing right there.
Now at the plate, David Peralta.
Now batting, left fielder, David.
Here's a rocket out to left. Drops for a hit. He couldn't run it down. Right past his coach, headed for the plate. He scores. It's 10-8.
Well done. Narrows the deficit with the RBI there. Put a pretty good swing on that one as he drove it out to deep left. Didn't quite have the right combination of launch angle and exit velocity to get it over the fence, but you're never going to be disappointed with extra bases.
Christian Walker stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
The first baseman, Christian.
Slapped foul.
Walker.
Pitch. Bounce to the right. BR picks it up. That's out number one. And a run comes in to score. Next to hit for Arizona, Josh Rojas.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate. Try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
Next pitch downstairs. And that's ball one. Next one is off the plate. And the count is 2-0. Swing and a ball popped up. BR drifts towards it. Puts the squeeze on that one. Two away down.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Here comes a new arm for the Cubs, Michael Rucker. And he'll be dealing with a runner on third.
Attention, please. Now pitching for Chicago, number 59, Michael Rucker.
Here's Ketel Marte.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Next offering is down low, and it's 1-0. Two outs with a runner at third. Next offering is in for a strike. two outs. So now one and two.
Well, he knows they don't want to give him anything to hit, but when you've got opportunities to drive in runs, you've got to expand the zone. He's capable of going out there and doing damage with it.
That missed inside, and it's three and two. Runner at third, two away. And a swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there. We're through six full. It's the Cubbies 10 and the D-backs 9. And welcome back. All set for the start of the inning. Digging in, Patrick Wisdom.
The third baseman, number 16, Patrick Wisdom.
Pitch and first offering is fouled off. And the righty deals out to short, and it's through for a hit.
Take notes on that swing, kids. That was a really nice breaking ball on the low outside corner, and he did all you can do with that pitch. He dropped the barrel down to it, stayed inside it with his hands, and just slapped it hard the opposite way.
Now it's going to be Frank Schwindel. First pitch, and he just misses. Righty delivers, and now 2-0.
He hasn't wanted to challenge him. Both of those pitches off the plate away. Don't expect anything down the heart of the plate. You may just have to be patient and take your walk here.
The 2-0 is in for a strike. The pitch.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
And now a full count. This one in the air, right field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away.
Up next for the Cubs, the center fielder.
Here's the center fielder, Jason Hayward. That one's in there, 0-1.
Well, he had a pretty good look at that pitch and not sure exactly what tied him up there. Couldn't pull the trigger, and perhaps the best pitch you'll see in this at bat to hit.
Left-hand batter waits. That's off the mark, and it's 1-1. And a pitch. Grounder might be two. Marte over to second, and it's a double play to end the inning. Midway in inning number 7, and it's time to stretch. It's the Cubbies 10 and the D-backs 9. Soft because you're like the gas tank over Mr. Softies in the winter. They ain't feeling you. See, every time you see me, I got something. Back here at Chase Field, bottom of the 7th, leading off Jordan Luplo.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks, the designated hitter. Jordan.
Wide to kick the pitch. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, this is just par for the course these days. Huge fastballs coming out of the bullpen.
Next one misses. One ball, one strike. Swing and a miss. One and two. Swing and a high fly ball. That one out towards left center field. Way back there. Oh! He sends it out of here. Home run number five on the season. And this game is tied. It's 10-10. Ziggy, he's been red hot.
Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he is really seeing the ball well in this one. A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
The batter number 13.
Next to hit, Nick Diamond. First offering, misses the mark.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
And the 1-0. That clips the corner. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The next pitch misses, and the count is 2-2.
That's a really good take.
Fought off foul. A wind in the pitch. On the ground to the left. Fires over to Schwindel, and that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer.
Now batter, number 36.
Now the catcher up to hit, Jose Herrera.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
And first offering is fouled off. One down, base is empty. Center field, Hayward has this one sized up. Puts the squeeze on it, two down.
The center fielder, number 12, Dalton Varsho.
Now up next for Arizona, Dalton Varsho. And first offering is fouled off. Right-handed reliever.
One ball, one strike.
Swing and a drive. This one is crushed. No doubt about it. And here in the late stages, they have the lead. He rockets one to right. His seventh home run of the season. It's 11-10. Singy, the ball is jumping off his bat.
Yes, it is. Tons of loud contact. Man, it's been impressive. Velocity up and in is just such a difficult location for the hitter, but this time he pulls the hands tight to the body, gets through this pitch. What conviction in that swing. Awesome job of the play.
New pitcher in the game for the Cubs, Michael Gibbons. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty. Haven Smith stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Now batting, right fielder, Haven.
In there, and it's 0-1.
Hey, partner, how's your scorecard looking right now?
A little dicey, kind of hieroglyphics style at the moment. You know what it's like, Singy? Remember our trip to London, Yankees and Red Sox in 2019? I think there were, 50 runs scored in the two games combined. My scorecard was ugly for that series.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he didn't like those first two pitches. Now in an 0-2 hole, he's going to have to battle. Hope he gets a mistake. One guy that was really great once the count got to two strikes, Miguel Cabrera.
Left-hand hitter waits. Swings and misses, and he's down on strikes for the second time today. Act like you're working. Hold up. I'm going to need you to put some work. Noe Ramirez into the game, trying to protect this lead.
Leading off with the second baseman, Jonathan Dion.
Pitch. VR in the box here lets that one go for a ball. Activity in the Arizona bullpen. Mark Melanson, the closer, getting cranked up for a possible save opportunity. Middleton getting loose as well. And fouled off. Kicks and deals. Hit hard. That gets through.
Well, a big swing of the bat right there. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
No outs. Runner at first. And here's the DH for the Cubs, Nico Horner. Known for his late inning heroics. 0-1.
Your base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Lays down a bunt to the right side. And that's a bunt single. That was placed perfectly.
This couldn't have played out any better on offense. They were trying to trade an out to move the runner into scoring position, but instead, they just couldn't make the play on defense. You really need to get it out there.
Back to the leadoff spot in the Cubs lineup. Wilson Contreras, the next Cub to hit. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, but not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
And the first offering is not close.
Well, this is a critical spot for both the pitcher and the hitter. You can learn a lot about a guy by how he handles these pressure situations.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Get a little frustrated with the strike zone.
And the pitch. Swing and a miss. And it's 1-2. Here comes a pitch. Strike three. Got him swinging. Now one away.
That was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially when two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
At the plate, Seiya Suzuki. First pitch doesn't find the zone. One out. The possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Next offering is in for a strike. On a line. And a base hit. Around third. The tag, and he's safe.
Well, he gets it done in a big spot to get the run across. Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
New pitcher now, Kanan Middleton. This is his fifth appearance of the year.
Kanan Middleton.
Ian Happ, the next Cub to hit, the Happ Daddy. out towards right center field. Barsha makes the play. Here comes the runner from third. He's in on the sacrifice fly. It's 12-11.
Well, it's a nice job right there. It's always great when you can get on the scoreboard first. Just good situational hitting to bring him home from third right there.
So now it's the Cubs hitter in the four hole, Yan Gomes. First pitch just misses. And he deals. Misses off the inside, and it's 2-0.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. With that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And a foul ball. Pickoff loop first. Suzuki dives back in safely. Next offering misses, and the count is 3-1. And here it comes. There's a strike.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Last half of the eighth coming up. The Cubs are on top 12-11. Welcome back. Bottom of the eighth. Now, here is David Peralta.
Leading up for the Diamondbacks, the left fielder, Peralta.
And a pitch. Just off the inside edge. Movement in the bullpen. Phillip McDermott, the anchor of the staff, is getting ready to close this one out. Thompson getting cranked up as well. The 1-0. This one in the air, center field. PR settles underneath it. Makes the catch. And there's one away.
That's a really nice play, ranging back into the outfield for that catch. We all know those can be a little tricky, especially if the wind's swirling around out there.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Christian Walker.
Well, he came up clutch earlier in this ball game and really just needs to take the same approach. Think hard right back up the middle.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
And I know you want to be patient as a hitter, but you got to be ready to jump on the first thing straight. And he got one right there, but left the bat on his shoulder.
Oh, now this is blasted way back there, on its way, gone. That'll fire up the dugout. It's his sixth home run of the season, and we're level. It's 12-12. That's their fourth home run of the game.
They can't stop, and they won't stop hitting home runs in this one, Boo. They're clearly feeding off of each other at the dip. Pitcher tried to intimidate with that fastball up and in, but he was ready for it. Pulled the trigger, and man, explosive through the zone right there.
Here's the third baseman, Josh Rojas. He's already homered in this game.
Now batter, the third baseman.
And that's in there for strike one. Offering upstairs. Back and forth we go. A seesaw battle in the late stages of this one. Out to short. Contreras gets it to first. And they got him.
Now back. Second baseman. Cattell. Marte.
An outstanding hitter in Cattell Marte. And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on. In there at the knees.
Oh, this guy's so comfortable hitting with two strikes. Even a good pitch early in the at bat. If he's not ready to pull the trigger, he's not worried if he gets to an 0-2 count.
Uh-oh, that got him. And the potential winning run is aboard.
Well, he's just glad they got hit with an off-speed pitch there instead of a fastball. Man, that would have hurt a lot more if it had velocity.
Looks like we've got a substitution at first. D-backs bringing on a pinch runner. Geraldo Perdomo.
Number two, Geraldo Perdomo.
In there for strike one. Check on the runner. Perdomo back on a dive. Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. Another throw. Yeah, they're keeping him close. The 0-1.
He's going, he's
runner
going.
Takes off. Pitch misses. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. But some late inning heroics as this home run gets us even again. Through eight full, you're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Some people called it rhythm and soul. I could never get enough of this kind of stuff because I think they call it rock and roll. Geraldo Perdomo comes on defensively now as he takes over as the new second baseman.
Now playing second.
Back here at the ballpark, new inning getting started. Here's a big power threat, Patrick Wisdom.
Leading off to the cut, the third baseman, Patrick
Middleton, back to work.
Wisdom.
And ball one. Pitch. Fouled off. He was late. At the belt and fires. That's outside. And it's 2-1.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at bats. And the biggest one he's had so far, he doesn't look anxious at all.
Next offering is way upstairs.
I almost feel like he's frustrated a little bit. He wants to be challenged.
Line drive. Peralta pulls it down, and there's one down.
The batter, the first baseman, Frank.
So digging in, Frank Schwindel. That one's in there, 0-1. The 0-1. Good eye in that spot. Misses outside, 2-1. That one in for a strike, 2-2. and the 2-2. And that one is lifted in the air. Parshall drops steps, heads back on it, pulls it in on the run. And there are two down.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Hayward, the next to hit, takes outside.
Backdoor breaking ball just missed right there, and boy, umpire to give him the call. I bet you if he throws it again, hitter knows he's going to have to swing it.
Next pitch misses, ball two. And the right hander deals. That one's spoiled, and the count now 2-1. Two outs. And there's a ball. High in the air, out to right. Smith going back. Back some more. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that'll do it. Cubs down quietly. This game remains tied at 12. Back here in the desert, all set for the bottom of the ninth. And now, Seth Beer.
Seth Beer.
The right-hander back to work. And a good fastball to start him off. That's strike one. Movement in the Cubs bullpen. Phillip McDermott, the closer, is getting loose. Thompson warming up as well. Pitch inside, just missed.
You don't want to get beat by a fastball in, and he spits on that one.
Oh, and this one's plastic. High and deep. It's on its way. Out of here. Ball game.
Hitting a walk-off homer is the kind of thing you dream about growing up. You're in the backyard, you're creating the most pressure-packed scenario, and what do? You come through with the big swing. Well, he was living a childhood moment right there. Nice swing of the bat, nice win for the team.
This one ends. Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi, saying so long.
Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.